Hello everyone, welcome back to another session in Dentistry and More. Today we have a very important topic in oral pathology, which comes under forensic dentistry, that is dental age estimation. On exam point of view, you would have one question from this topic in every question paper. Sometimes it will be Gustafson methods, DEMIRJIAN'S methods, or histologic method, or simply dental age estimation. So you just cannot skip this chapter for on exam point of view. So mostly asked questions are the dental age estimation, then the histologic method of dental age estimation, Gustafson's or DEMIRJIAN'S method. So let's see one by one. This will be dealt in a few sessions. Today's session is about the two methods, that is the morphological method, Gustafson, and the radiologic method, DEMIRJIAN'S. So we'll start with some basic idea of dental age or age estimation. So age estimation is an important factor in biological identification in many forensic fields, such as forensic odontology, forensic medicine, forensic anthropology, and forensic osteology. So it helps to narrow the search possibilities for unidentified dead people or living individuals, mainly for the legal purpose. And it also helps to determine the age of criminals for mainly those who are in the younger age group, because the age, if they are adult, the punishment they get is different, and if they are minor, the punishment they get is different. So in order to prove their real age, we can depend on the various methods. So therefore, accuracy of age estimation methods for suspects with unknown chronological age who are involved in any type of crime is needed in the interest of justice. So first we need to understand few terminologies, that is, what is chronological or real age, what is skeletal age, and what is dental age. The first one is chronological or real age, that is measured by the calendar. Sometimes it be a period of intrauterine development or number of years after birth. So this is a commonly known method of age estimation, that is a chronological age. Whereas a skeletal age, which is determined by the degree of ossification or development of various bones, which is known to occur at a particular time in average individual. So we calculate skeletal age by comparing with the ossification or development of various bones. So every bone has a particular pattern of ossification. So we correlate with those bones and calculate the skeletal age. Finally, the dental age, which is determined by studying development of various teeth from time of crypt formation. Crypt is when the crypt is visible, till the time of root completion. So we have a pattern or a time period where each step of a tooth formation happens for a particular tooth. So it will not vary much in people. So we can correlate those standardized stage of tooth development or a particular tooth and calculate the dental age. So that is what we are going to learn. The dental age estimation. So we have lots of method for skeletal age estimation. So today's session is about, or the future sessions are mainly on, the dental age estimations. So we have few methods for dental age estimation. They are morphologic or visual examination, radiographic examination, histologic examination, and biochemical examination. The morphologic or visual examination, which are based on the assessment of teeth, that is XYO measurement. So XYO means in a living person. So these methods require extracted teeth for microscopic preparation. So if we if a person in a dispute of his age identification, we need to extract the person's tooth. But these methods may not be acceptable due to ethical, religious, cultural, or scientific reasons. So that is morphologic or visual examination. This is basically ex vivo method, which is done in persons by removing the persons, that is in a living person. So to extract the tooth, we have many problems. So this method is quite difficult. So we have the most commonly used morphological method. They are Gustafsson method, and many methods are there, such as Solhe methods, Maples method, Johansson methods. But the main problem is which is not possible to be performed in a living person, because we need to take out the tooth and do a ex vivo study, that is outside the tooth with minimal alteration of that specimen. That is ethically it's not at all a good thing. So it is not possible in living person. Whereas the biochemical method, biochemical methods are based on the amino acids. So the amino acid and the racemization of these amino acids. So the racemization of amino acid is a reversible first order reaction, and which is relatively rapid in living tissues in which metabolism are slow. The racemization. So we can correlate with the racemization process of this amino acid. So the aspartic acid has been reported to have highest racemization rate of all amino acids and to be stored during aging. So which can be correlated, and age can be calculated, that is the biochemical methods. So the Ritz et al. Method, Ritz et al. Method, and the Helfman and Bada method, all are under biochemical methods. Whereas the radiographic method, this follows the pattern of maturation of teeth. So we know teeth having the growth from its crypt to the root formation. It starts from birth and even it starts in the utero for the deciduous teeth, and it starts from birth for the permanent teeth, such as it's starting the first permanent molars during the birth and around 7-8 years, and it goes on for the second molars. So we can correlate various stages of calcification, the root formation, root completion, crown formation, and the layers of crown formation, dentine, enamel. All those can be calculated or do a radiographic examination and correlate with the standard tables. So such method is known as the radiographic method. The most commonly used is the DEMIRJIAN'S method. So DEMIRJIAN'S has formulated a table for boys and girls, and he classified 8 stages where can correlate the formation step or the stage of its formation and convert the stage into a score, add all the teeth score and make the age estimation. So we'll be dealing these two methods in detail. And this radiographic method is a simple one, which is a simple, non-invasive and reproducible method, because we are taking radiographs, and which can be employed both on living and the unknown dead people. So various radiographic images that can be used in age identification are IOPAs, lateral oblique radiographs, cephalograms, the OPGs or digital imaging, and any advanced imaging technologies. Now let's focus on mainly the DEMIRJIAN'S method and Gustafsson method. So in the radiographic method, the most common one is DEMIRJIAN'S method. So this DEMIRJIAN'S method actually started in 1973 by a group of people. So it uses the 7 teeth in the left side of mandible, that is the third quadrant teeth. That is central incisor, lateral incisor, canine, first, second premolar, and first, second molar. So this is the left side of mandible, that is the third quadrant teeth. 7 teeth are used. And they used stages A to H, that is a stage which is having a minimal calcification or tooth formation, and to the last stage. So these stages were used to mark the developmental stage of the tooth in the suspect. That is, the stages were formulated by DEMIRJIAN'S, which has usually marked by recognizable tooth shapes from the beginning of calcification through to final mature form. So these stages must be easily recognizable, and such that a tooth always passes through the same stage in every individual. So it can be easily correlated and calculated. So since these stages are indicators of maturity and not of the size, they cannot be defined by any absolute length measurement. So we first select the 7 teeth. Okay, so we start from the second molar, then first molar, second, first premolars, canine, lateral incisor, and central incisor. And all the teeth, all the 7 teeth, are rated on a scale A to H. Okay, so the rating is assigned by following carefully the written criteria for each stage and by comparing the tooth with the diagram and x-ray pictures given for comparison. And for each stage there are 1, 2, or 3 written criteria, which is marked by A, B, and C. So you can see here the stages of DEMIRJIAN'S, that is A to H, and its characteristics. So the stage A, that means you can see the picture here. It is a calcification of single occlusal points without fusion of different calcification. So we are going to compare it with our tooth and whether it matches the stage A or not. Whereas the stage B, fusion of mineralization points, the contour of occlusal surface is recognizable. So we compare the x-ray film of that particular mandibular third quadrant teeth with these images and find out where exactly our tooth matches. So stage A, stage B, as occlusal surface recognizable, whereas stage C is much more formation has happened, enamel formation completed at occlusal surface and dentine formation has started, pulp chamber is curved and no pulp horns. So that is stage C. So we need to match it with our x-ray for each tooth. Then stage D, crown formation completed at till the level of CJ, root formation started, pulp horns are started, but the walls of pulp chamber remain curved. Whereas the stage E, the root length remains shorter than the crown height, the walls of pulp chamber are straight, and the pulp horns have become more differentiated than in the previous stage. Whereas the stage F, the walls of pulp chambers now form a triangle and the root length is equal to or greater than the crown height. In molars, the bifurcation has developed sufficiently to give the root a distinct form. So we are comparing the x-rays of our particular patient's third quadrant teeth with the DEMIRJIAN'S A to H stages. And finally, we have G and H stages. In G stage, the walls of the root canal are now parallel, but the apical end is open. And H, the root apex is completely closed. The periodontal membrane surrounding the root and apex is uniform and width throughout. So A is the beginning of calcification and tooth formation. H is the completion. So we need to compare A to H stages with our tooth. Okay. So I told you, for every stage we may have 1, 2, or 3 criterias. Okay. So 1, 2, 3 criterias. If just one criteria is there for a particular stage, So we need to fulfill that criteria for to correlate with our tooth to that stage. If we are getting the criteria, we can score the particular tooth to that stage. If we have two criteria, then it is sufficient if the first one of them is met for the stage to be recorded. If three are there, I mean three criteria are there, we need to match the first two. Okay. Each stage, in addition to the criteria for that stage, the criteria for the previous stage also must be satisfied. So in borderline cases, we can go with the earliest stage. So that is how we do assessment. That means the A to H. So we the first step is we are putting our teeth into various stages of tooth formation. The next step is convert this stage, what we obtained for each tooth, to a score, that is a numerical value. So here what you see is a table for boys and girls. Okay, that is self weight score for dental stages of 7 teeth. You can see the 7 teeth. Okay, and stages for boys and girls. You can see the incisors, lateral incisor, canine, premolars and molars. So we have various stages, that is A to H, A, B, C, D, E, F, G and H. And for each stage, for each tooth, where a particular score is there. This is a standardized score and we need to convert our stage into this score value. Okay, so suppose if we have a score that is the molar 1, the first molar, we got E. Okay, so from our first stage, that A to H stage, for the first molar, this tooth for a particular boy, we found out that it belongs to the stage E. Okay, so then we go to this table and we check the boys and first molar score, where exactly is coming. Score E, which is coming around 9.6. Okay. So that is the first molar. If it is the second premolar, it will be 12. Then first premolar, it will be 11. So for each stage, for each tooth, it varies. So this is standardized score. So we have 7 stages here. Okay. So it will be sometimes B, sometimes H, sometimes G, A, like that. Okay. So now we are converting all this score into numerical values based on the standardized scores. Now we got 7 scores. Okay, so all these alphabets, that is the A to H stages, alphabets are turned into numerical scores. After that, we are going to add up all the individual scores. So we need to add 7 individual score of 7 teeth. So that's how we get the final maturity score. That is the added value of 7 individual scores. Okay. So once we get this maturity score, our job is almost done. Now we need to assess the age of that person, assess the dental age of a person from a standardized chart. So these charts, they are the DEMIRJIAN'S charts for all the 7 teeth. Okay. So 7 teeth maturity score can be compared with this table, that is separate for the boys and separate for the girls. So we get a value and we are going to correlate with this table. Okay, so we can see the age here from 3 to 16. So 3 starting from the score 12.4 and it is ending in a 98.4 by the age of 16. So after calculation, suppose we get a value of 45. Okay, for boys, for it is separate for boys and girls. So if we get a value of 45, we need to check the score 45 in the boys table. So it is coming somewhere here, that is 6 years and 9 months. So we finally found out the dental age of that particular person is to be 6 years and 9 months from our calculation. That is the easiest method. We can also by plotting on a centile charts where the age of the child is known. Dental age, that is how we calculate the dental age using the radiographic method, that is DEMIRJIAN'S method. So the best part of DEMIRJIAN'S method, it is very simple and it is very reproducible, and it has got good intra-examiner and inter-examiner reliability, and it is very widespreadly used because of its the maturity scoring system, which creates a universal application. But we need to taken into consideration of the population being considered, because it may vary from population to population because of this dental and skeletal characteristics. At the same time, it has a few disadvantages, that is getting the OPG, which are difficult from younger children due to many technical reasons and legal or ethical consideration. And also, it doesn't have maturity scores for stages 1 to 4 in case of first molar, central and lateral incisor. So excluding the individual who are below 4 to 4.5 years. It's very commonly used because it can be used in both living and dead persons. In a nutshell, we can say that the entire process, the first thing is the 7 mandibular teeth. Each teeth are divided to 8 stages, that is 8 to H stages, and each tooth is assigned a individual maturity score that corresponds to its developmental stage. Then each individual maturity score is added and a total maturity score is obtained. Then this total score is plotted on a chronologic age conversion table. So the final table will give you the dental age of that person. That's all about DEMIRJIAN'S method of dental age estimation, which is basically a radiographic age estimation method commonly applied in adolescents and young age group, younger children, because it solely depends on the tooth calcification stages. Once the tooth calcification of teeth is complete, this method is no longer used or applicable. So next session is about the Gustafson method of morphological age estimation, which is mostly used in the adults. So I'll come up with that method in my next session. Thank you.